Now children, carbon on the basis of attachment of carbon, right? When electron deficient carbon is attached with one more carbon, that carbon is called as primary carbocation, right? When electron deficient carbon or carbocation is attached with two more carbon atoms, then secondary carbocation. With three carbon atoms, tertiary carbon atom. Tertiary carbocation. Now what is the structure of carbocation? Carbocation is electron deficient chemical species. Cation is positive one, right? Which is electron deficient chemical species. What is the structure of hybrid structure of carbocation? This is showing trigonal planar. Carbon atom, electron deficient carbon is sp2 hybridized, right? This is showing planar arrangement. In any type of carbocation, primary, secondary or tertiary, what is the shape of carbocation? Planar. And type of hybridization of carbon, carbocation is sp2 hybridized. This carbocation is attached with three other groups in tertiary carbocation, three alkyl groups. In secondary carbocation, two alkyl and one hydrogen. And primary carbocation, one alkyl and two hydrogen atoms. But its shape, its geometry is planar. This is orbital structure of carbocation. This angle is fixed, right? If alkyl groups are attached, then carbon-carbon-carbon bond angle is of 120 degree. Okay, children? sp2, it means this bond angle. Right? Short answer question. Draw this hybrid structure or orbital structure of carbocation is the answer. Right? In carbon ion, different structure due to the presence of one lone pair of electron. In free radical, different due to the presence of odd electron. But this is the hybrid structure of carbocation only. Right? First part. Orbital structure of carbocation. Right? Another important concept is hyperconjugation. Children, tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary carbocation. Right? Due to maximum hyperconjugation in tertiary carbocation. Secondary carbocation is more stable than primary carbocation due to average hyperconjugation or more hyperconjugation in secondary carbocation than primary. Primary carbocation is more stable than methyl carbocation. Methyl means CH3+. There is no hyperconjugation. Right? What is hyperconjugation? One is inductive effect. Inductive effect means partial shifting of sigma bonded electrons towards more electronegative atom. Resonance, interconversion of structures due to the presence of pi electrons and lone pair of electrons. Right? Or lone pair of electrons. Now, third effect is hyperconjugation effect or hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation is also known as no bond resonance. In this concept, in this phenomenon, what happens? Overlapping between, according to this example, ethyl carbocation, overlapping of CH bond electrons, it means sigma electrons and empty p orbitals. This is electron deficient center, which is carbocation, then overlapping between empty p orbital of carbocation and sigma electrons of CH bond, right? In adjacent carbon atom, this overlapping is called hyperconjugation. Right? Pi bond means overlapping between 3 electrons, p electrons. Right? But hyper state, because this is electron deficient state. Okay, children? Now, this is showing shifting. This is alpha carbon, which is attached with carbocation. 3 alpha hydrogen atoms are attached. Right? Then overlapping of CH bond electrons with empty p orbital of carbocation 1 by 1. After bond cleavage, after heterolysis of CH, heterolysis, this sigma bonded electron pair goes to this carbon atom. Right? And then formation of double bond between C and C. Right? This is showing double bond between C and C after heterolysis or heterolytic cleavage of CH bond. Next step, reshifting. Reshifting of this electron on this carbon, formation of bond between C and H. And bond cleavage of second carbon hydrogen bond. Right? This is showing heterolysis. Again, formation of double bond. This electron, this double bond provides stability to this carbocation, electron deficient species. Right? Second time. This is showing second time cleavage. Right? Now, next step, again reshifting, rebond formation and heterolysis or bond cleavage of CH bond. Right? And this is showing CH bond cleavage. Again, formation of this pair of electrons, this lone pair of electrons forms bond, pi bond between two carbon atoms. Total, how many times hyperconjugation is possible in this ethyl carbocation? 3 times. Because only 3 alpha hydrogen atoms are present. This is ethyl carbocation. Right? CH3C2H5. What is its formula? C2H5 plus or CH3CH2 plus. Right? This is a carbocation of ethyl group, which is also known as ethyl carbocation. Okay? Now each structure is showing stability of this carbocation by which process? By hyperconjugation. Now next is hyperconjugation in alkene. Alkene, this is propene. CH2 double bond CH, CH3. Okay, children? Propene 1. Now, after shifting of pi bonded electrons, this is pi bond, pi bonded electrons on this carbon atom, this shifting of electrons initiates bond cleavage of CH bond. Which bond? Which electrons? Sigma electrons. Same step, but here system is unsaturated. Here system is unsaturated. After shifting, then this carbon becomes cation, electron deficient. Then shifting of sigma electrons between this and this carbon. This figure, next step, next structure is showing formation of pi bond, double bond between C and C. Right? How many alpha hydrogen atoms are present here? 3 alpha hydrogen, 1, 2, 3. How many times hyperconjugation occurs? 3 times. Right? 1, 2. Repetition of same step. Formation of bond between 2 and bond cleavage of second carbon hydrogen bond. Right? Double bond. This is second time. Hyperconjugation, and this is third time after cleavage of the CH bond. Right? The stability is provided to this electron deficient carbon. Right? What is the significance? What is the advantage of hyperconjugation? Hyperconjugation increases the stability. Right? This is the order of stability of carbocation. Tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary carbocation. And this is more stable than primary carbocation. Right? If alkyl group is CH3, then 9 times hyperconjugation in tertiary carbocation. Again, CH3 groups are attached. Then 6 times hyperconjugation in secondary carbocation. One CH3 group is present, then 3 like this. 3 times hyperconjugation in primary carbocation. This is primary carbocation. This carbocation is attached with carbon. This is primary carbocation. And in methyl carbocation, there is no alkyl group. Least stable. Which carbocation is least stable? CH3+. Which one is most? Tertiary carbocation. And this is the reason. Hyperconjugation. Right? Increasing number of structures, contributing structures, increases the stability of carbocation. Okay, children? Important concept. Now next, this is orbital diagram. This diagram is showing hyperconjugation. CH3, this part. CH3 part. This part. 1, 2, 3. Then CH, this part. Double bond. Double bond. Only one set of double bond. Okay, but this is the mode of formation of double bond above the plane and below the plane. Only one pi bond is present, like this. And this is CH2. Right, children? Pi bond between carbon-carbon. One pi bond. And after hyper, you know, what happens? After shifting of pi electrons to this carbon, then hyperconjugation. This sigma electron pair, right? C and H. Sigma electron pair is in conjugation with pi electrons. This is called sigma pi conjugation. Hyperconjugation between sigma electrons and pi electrons. Okay, children? This is orbital diagram for this concept, hyperconjugation. Okay, children? And first of all, who noticed this conjugation, this hyperconjugation? Baker and Nathan. This effect is also known as Baker and Nathan effect. Hyperconjugation effect, Baker and Nathan effect, or no bond resonance. Here is no formation of permanent bond. This is also known as no bond resonance. Okay, children?